Hello, and welcome to this product overview of LogMeIn Resolve. My name is Keegan, and I will be showing you a product demonstration of what LogMeIn Resolve can offer you. We have brought a lot of the products from our IT suite, such as LogMeIn Central, LogMeIn Rescue. We brought all those features into LogMeIn Resolve to give you more of an all-inclusive tool to be able to provide support from the start of your support cycle all the way to the end. This includes things like device monitoring, RMM capabilities, even ad hoc support, and brings you through the process of dealing with tickets and having access to a help desk solution. And at the end, we'll provide reporting for you to be able to see what you've been doing on a day-to-day basis. So with that being said, let's dive into what Resolve looks like and how it functions. We are in LogMeIn Resolve. This is where I would go to access any of the features that I need to be able to provide support for my end users. Like I mentioned earlier, you can easily access your help desk solution, you can access your unattended devices, and much more. To start things off, I'm in my devices page. This is where I would go to access any unattended device, meaning I have an unattended agent running on those devices currently and can access them whenever I need. If I needed to jump into a specific device, I could easily search by the device properties of that computer, and then I will be filtered down into the computer that I want to access. In this case, I can see some really important information. First off, I can see my device health, and I can see that that's in critical status. I can see that the device is currently online and the end user is present. And I can get a better grasp of what this device is as I drill down a little bit deeper. So as I click into this computer, I'm greeted with a page that shows me the details of this specific computer. So no matter where you are at, if you have a hybrid environment or a completely remote environment, you can easily see what device you're accessing and get some better understanding of what it is. In this case, I can see that I'm accessing a virtual machine. I can see the processor information, and I can even see simple things like the last boot time or the last logged in user. Now, beyond that, if I come to my performance page, this is going to give me visibility as to what's happening on this device right now. So if I needed to provide troubleshooting for this computer before even remoting into the device or running a specific command, I can see if there's anything out of the ordinary. In this case, has my CPU spiked? What's going on with my network? And I can also see things like how full is my hard drive. This gives me a better understanding of what I'm going to be getting into as I provide support for this computer. Now, there's some things that I can also do from this page, things like ending a certain process. So maybe there's a rogue process that's happening. I can end that directly from here. As I take a look on the right-hand side, there's some more options that I have. Things like starting a remote control session, which is pretty straightforward. This is where you can actually get onto a device, take over it as if you were physically standing in front of it. There's some other things that I can do in the background, like launching the terminal. This is going to give me access to PowerShell scripting, so I can easily run a PowerShell execution directly in the background without interrupting that end user. I can also do things like transferring files to or from that device with our file manager. I can edit the registry and even start and stop services directly from here. So on an individual device basis, I can easily troubleshoot this computer, take care of any issues that it has, and move on to my next issue that I have to take care of. Now, if I look over here on the left-hand side, it's great to be able to manage a device on an individual device basis, but I'm sure there's things that you would need to do more on a global scale. In that case, I can do things like remote execution. This gives me the ability to run a script, install software, just do something on one or multiple devices at the same time. So as I come in here and create a job, I can do things like running a PowerShell execution on multiple devices. I can restart devices, do file operations, and I can even do things like MSI installs, giving me a lot of power at my fingertips to be able to handle things on more of a global scale. Beyond that, there are a lot of other options that I can do as far as RMM capabilities, such as running updates on my devices and even creating policies to automate those updates. I can also manage my antivirus, even set proactive alerts. for my computers. This could be being aware of any time your disk space is getting full on a specific computer, connectivity for your servers, and much more. So within that realm, I have a lot of capability to be able to manage my devices on an individual scale as well as a global scale. Now beyond that, there may be cases where you need to provide more of an ad hoc support, meaning I need to get in, get out, and leave nothing behind. In that case, I come to my support page. This gives me potentially three options that I can provide support for my end users. One of those would be instant remote support, which allows me to provide troubleshooting for computers like Macs or PCs. I also can have the capability of providing mobile device support. This gives me the ability to see the screen of an iOS device or even control the screen of an Android device, whether that's a tablet or cell phone. And beyond that, I can even help troubleshoot things that are maybe more physical hardware through camera share. This allows me to see through the lens of the end user's device and help walk them through maybe troubleshooting a router, or maybe there's a printer issue that I need to see. This gives me a lot of capability within there to manage that. Now, just to show you some of the capabilities that you have with support session, if I were to come to start an instant support session for a computer, for example, I can easily send them this link or even direct them to helpdesk.me and have them punch in this 9-digit code. And then it will walk me through where that end user is at in the setup process. So if I look below, I can see the next steps. See that, you know, once the end user clicks on that link, they will then be prompted with the download application button. And then from there, I can walk them through. So I already have a session started over here on the left-hand side. If I come to, you know, a specific remote session, I can see now that I'm in this device, I can easily walk through what I need to do to be able to troubleshoot it. This gives me full control to be able to do what I need. I can even do things like launching the admin mode, so that way I have access to UAC prompts and can take care of maybe more installation type issues or running as admin issues. I will have the capabilities that you would expect from a remote session, like managing files, even doing Control-Alt-Delete, and being able to just make sure that I'm providing the best support for my end users. Now, some things to take note of on the right-hand side. I'm on the notes page right now, and this allows me to take notes for the specific session that I can then access later in a report to see what was done in this session. These sessions can also be recorded, so you can keep those recordings for training purposes or maybe quality control. But as I come in here, if I want to take notes, we also have AI built in here, and I can have AI take the notes for me. What that will do is it will just basically take what I'm doing on the screen and write down what I'm doing, just making it so much easier for me as a technician to be able to do my job without having to take the time to write notes and things of that nature. So in this case, if I needed to come to my settings, it's going to grab that information on the right-hand side. And then once I'm done troubleshooting, I can then move on. Now there's some other options here, such as chatting with the end user. I can even see device info. So as I'm troubleshooting, I can see if anything is spiking and take care of the issue at hand. Now, once I'm done with that session, I can go ahead and end it. And it's going to give me a moment to finish out any other notes that I have. If I want to edit what AI did for me and maybe tailor it a little bit more, I can do that as well. And then I can move on to the next session. In this case, as I come to my other session, this is going to be a mobile device support session. And this, I'm accessing my iPad right here. And it's very easy for me to walk through what the end user needs to do to troubleshoot a specific issue. Since this is an iOS device, I can only see that. But if I needed to walk them through settings, it's going to allow me to see exactly what they see. So there's no guessing, there's no Googling, you know, where my end user is at or walking through those steps, I can now easily see where they're at and walk them through what they need to do to fix the issue. Now, one more thing to note here is no matter what session you're running, whether it's an unattended session, ad hoc support, or even this mobile device support, it's going to allow me to take notes, record those sessions and do what I need to provide the support. Now, moving on, that allows us to provide ad hoc support for our end users. Again, very valuable tools at your fingertips. But to take it a step further, if we come to our help desk solution, this allows me to manage all of the tickets that lie within my organization. Now, a couple things to take note of here is, one, as far as ticket submission, there's a few options that you have. You can manually add a ticket in here. You can tie it to an email or email alias to have tickets automatically generated in here when that email is submitted. We also have a Teams integration as well as an end user portal. So there's quite a few options of ticket submission, the different ways that you can run these, receive these tickets. But just to show you what a ticket looks like, if I come in here, Laura's having an issue with logging into a VPN. I can see that we had some AI help her out in our end user portal to kind of walk through maybe some potential steps there to get that resolved, but it seems like it didn't resolve the issue. So I can then come in here and assign this ticket to myself. And I can even see a few things on the right-hand side that we've recently added are insights. So if there's any related knowledge base article that I have within Resolve that senses that this could be a potential fix for it, it's going to allow me to see those knowledge base articles, as well as any similar tickets that have been opened recently. So I can see if there's a potential larger issue with the VPN, for example. Now, beyond that, I can do things like starting a support session directly from here. I can even add a linked device. So this would be one of my unattended devices to see that this ticket is specifically associated with this device. Beyond that, I can add session history as well as track my time in here. And then, you know, if I have more issues with this specific ticket, if I need more context, I can write comments in here, and that can be conversational with Laura. So she can receive an email stating that Keegan has more questions, and it will fill that in for her, and then she can then respond from there. So very nice to be able to have this help desk solution in place and manage everything from within one window pane. Now, a couple other things just to take note of is we have problem management, which allows me to take issues that may be on a larger scale, such as, you know, our VPN issues that we've seen an increase in tickets there, and tie it to a problem to where we can manage that globally rather than on an individual ticket basis, just making things a little bit easier for you. Another feature that lies within LogMeIn Resolve is our inventory or asset tracking. This allows me to bring over, you know, my unattended devices that I have already in Resolve, as well as any other devices that I want to keep track of or take care of. In this case, I can import from a template, and I can manage all of my devices in here, see all the assets that I have, whether it's a computer or a peripheral device, and I can just have a nice list here rather than using an Excel sheet or maybe an Access database. I can now see all of my devices in here, and I can search for them within here. So as I drill down, you can see that it's brought over some really helpful information from my unattended devices, such as serial number, Windows build, things of that nature. So overall, just gives me a good grasp of my environment and what assets I have in there. Now, there's a lot more I could cover in this product overview, but I essentially wanted to provide you an understanding of how LogMeIn Resolve functions, what it looks like, and some of the potential features that you'd have access to. Now, there's a lot more that can be accessed, such as software assets, knowledge base, and even a mobile device management solution. So we have this broad scale of all the different features that LogMeIn Resolve has to offer, just to provide more of a single pane of glass for you. Thank you for taking the time with me to walk through LogMeIn Resolve. If you have any additional questions, feel free to go to logmein.com/products/resolve to get any additional information. Thanks for your time. Have a nice day.